Grace and peace be multiplied unto you all in the name of Jesus Christ. Right now I want to illustrate something. Here I have a 3-cup container, and what I'm going to do is, and I have some salt. What I'm going to do is I'm going to just use in this container here, I'm just going to use just like a few drops of salt into it. Just a few drops. There you go. Just a few grains of salt in that container. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to fill that container all the way up to 3 cups of water. 3 cups of water. There you go. And then I'm just going to stir it around a little bit with a spoon. There you go. Now, amazing as it sounds, that small amount of salt in the water, when you drink that thing, it still has a flavor. It flavors the water. Now, I'm not asking you to drink the salt water. What I'm going to actually do, what I actually did with this water is I used it to gargle with, because salt is actually alkaline. It's very strong. It's slightly alkaline. And so what it does with the water is it changes the pH of the water. The water is supposed to be about pH 7. It goes to above pH 7. And when you gargle that in your mouth, it actually destroys small microbes that might be in your mouth, which could cause cavities, diseases, etc. Of course, you can brush first and then use this slightly salinated water to gargle with and to rinse your mouth with. I just have a few other things that you can utilize with that. You can use this, which is your typical apple cider vinegar with it. And you can use some peppermint, which you would find in your cupboard somewhere, if you have peppermint. And peppermint's what's used in toothpaste. So simple things like apple cider, which is a very weak, vinegar is actually just a very weak acid. And I use common sea salt, but you can use your table salt, just a few grains of that in 3 cups of water with just a speckle or just a drop of apple cider. You can also use very, very limited portions of 3% hydrogen peroxide. That thing is, it destroys everything, so you really want to be careful with that. All right, now the point behind the salt and the water is, salt has this effect where it actually purifies. And a small amount of salt in 3 cups of water has a tremendous effect on purifying the mouth. And the spiritual application to this, the spiritual understanding is that we being the salt of the earth, and the water being the spirit of man, or the men in the earth, just a little bit of that salt has a profound effect of purifying the men around us. So when you go to pray for the forgiveness of sins of your neighbors. Grace and peace be multiplied unto you all.